Hi everyone, welcome and welcome back to my channel. My name is Alliyiah, and for today's video, we are going to be talking about how to build confidence. So I did film this outside, but I didn't like it as much because it was really loud outside because of the birds. The birds wouldn't be quiet at all. But anyways, we're going to film this inside now, and I have some down in this book that I got a few years ago. It's one of my favorite books. It's really pretty. But anyways, let's get to the intro, and I'll see you guys after. Let's get into this. So I have about 4 to 5 main points that I want to talk about that I wrote down in my journal, as I said before, the intro. So let's get into it. First topic is negative thoughts. You need to find your negative thoughts and sort of like take them away. What I would say to do, or what I would do, is I would just take the negative thoughts and try to just not think about any of them. It's very, and that's more easier said than done, pretty much. Black, as you say. Okay. Alright, starting. So first thing is to find a negative self-talk and negative self-doubt and thoughts and turn them into positive. Now, I know that's easier said than done, but don't worry, I have some tips that can help you, okay? So, first, you'll be self-aware of your negative thoughts. I know all of us think that we're really bad at math and that depression or teen depression is new cool. Well, really, it's not cool because it's talking about actual serious context. I know for me, I have anxiety, not bad anxiety, but like social anxiety sometimes. So yeah, and a lot of people, they have actual bad depression that can lead up to suicidal thoughts and things like that. But I just think that we should take our negative self-talk and turn it into positive. You know, if we say we're going to, if, for example, we have a math test, and you say, I'm going to make a bad grade in a math test, I've studied, but I still feel like I'm not going to make it, or I'm not going to pass that test, then you're not going to pass. But if you speak positively about it, and you actually study, and you feel like you memorize the content, or you have the content memorized to a point where you understand it, then you'll do a good job. It's all about targeting the negative thoughts, getting rid of them, and placing them in with positive ones. That brings us into our next one, our next tip, which is discovering yourself. So that plays a big crucial role in finding your self-confidence and building it. So discovering yourself, discovering your talents, things like that, and like your fashion sense or what you like to wear, and like your style and more. So for me, I didn't realize I liked journalism or writing until like just like 2 years ago. I didn't know I liked doing YouTube until about 8th grade, you know, things like that. I didn't know, like, in 7th grade I played the cornet, and I was a little later than everybody else, but I still learned how to play. That's the talents that I know I have. But some stuff I tried and it didn't work out for me, like fashion designing. I wanted to be a fashion designer because I thought it was a cool job, but it's not for me. I think I'm more of the styling type than the actual sitting down with fabrics and designing type. That's where I think I got it mixed up. But I have this great fashion book out of it that I use, so that's great. Anyways, with that being said, also spend time with yourself. We're stuck in quarantine. I know you guys are not busy. You're just on your phone scrolling from social media. Take a break and get to know yourself. Read audiobooks, do things like that. Some apps that I recommend will be down below as well. But also, you know, do things like that. You know, read, write, listen to podcasts, and do other things like that. Okay. Next is having a positive attitude. Positive attitude plays an important role of having self-confidence. Without that positive attitude, you're just at the bottom. Okay, but you want to get to the top. So what I want to say is have that positive attitude. I know sometimes it can be really hard with all the things that are going on right now in the world, but I promise you, it's all worth it. For me, for example, I just started speaking more positively, things like that, and a lot of good things have been happening to me. And you know, a lot of positive self-talk makes me more happy and things like that. And it should work for you as well. Like, if you speak positive things are going to happen. You know, I've watched a lot of things that are more how would I put this, more fitting to my soul than this comedy. Stop comparing yourself to beauty standards. Beauty standards, I don't really believe in them, but the world does. You know, like the so-called perfect person, I don't think it's more realistic than the next person. You know, the beauty standards are all Photoshop, plastic, just like a Barbie doll. That's pretty much it. So I think everybody is the way they were for a reason, you know? Like, for example, for me, I've been bullied since I was a little kid because I have, like, okay, so before I get interrupted, I have like 4 minutes and 35 seconds before this goes off because my phone is timed. Let me take off my headphones too. Oh my gosh. Okay. So that brings us into what I think you guys should remember, as well as trying to find your self-confidence. Do what makes you happy. Don't compare yourself to others. Now, I know this is so cliche, and every person, whoever made these videos, says it. I know. But hear me out. Okay, so I know it's easier said than done, but try it. Try not to compare yourself to others. This, if you see somebody on Instagram that you know that inspires you, yes, you can follow them. But if you're sitting there picking at yourself and like saying, I need this to be improved and this to be improved and I don't look like this person, then that means that they're toxic for you. They're toxic for you. They're not necessarily doing anything to you, but they're toxic to your brain, because we're taught from a young age that beauty standards is being a certain way, looking a certain way, and more. So you want to not like follow those people. Like, that's what I'm trying to do. But I follow a lot of people, so that's going to take me a long time trying to follow a lot of people that I don't really, you know, pay attention to anymore. So, okay. Do what you want, and what else? Oh, I read this in a book that I was reading yesterday on Wattpad because I was bored, so I searched up ways to be confident, things like that. And I read like 2 books, or not really read, I more of skimmed through it because I didn't feel like reading all of it. This is coming from a person who takes AP, who's taking AP World Language next year. Or is it AP Lit? I don't remember. Anyways, The World Is Your Red Carpet. Rock It, Own It, Keep Your Head Up, one of my favorite songs by Tupac, Keep Your Head Up, and Wear That Crown and Tiara, because Own It. You know, sometimes I have to think that I'm wearing like a tiara on my head, like it's an imaginary one, but it's there. And you know, when you're little, and like if you're a girl or whatever, when you're little and you put on your little Princess Bella shoes or whatever, those little, I don't know, I'll put one on the screen right here, those little shoes. They're not like from the dollar store, but like the Disney ones, and like you had your own tiara on and you would dress up. Yeah, and you just do this and pretend you're a princess. Have that same attitude except you're older. The world sort of takes us away from our core selves, like we were when we were younger. The world and things that we go through, experiences, they take us away from that core person that you were in the very beginning. And you have to somehow find your way back as you get older and wiser. That's pretty much what you have to do. And I found that out from her name. And her critic is Lior Alexandra, one of my favorite YouTubers. Such a great inspiration. And some things that I like to do, some actions that I like to do to keep myself in a positive headspace and keep my confidence up, is I've been doing this for about a few months now, but I've kind of stopped. Because I realize I just dance to myself. I just say them to myself as soon as I get up. Like, they start playing in my head. Like, it's like a song. It's kind of confusing. So, affirmations. You know, I write down some affirmations. And I say them in the mirror 3 times. And I just say them every day. And I write 1 good thing about myself. Or 1 to 3 good things about myself. Pretty much. And that helps me stay grounded and say, like, hey, there's some good things about myself as well. Although there's some things I would want to fix, there are amazing great things about myself. You know, speak positive. If you speak positive, you receive positive things. But if you don't speak positive, you sort of get what you put in the universe. You get what you get. So if you put negativity in the universe and you say, if you're a teenager like me, I used to say I want money all the time, and I was like, I have abundance and all this type of stuff. That's probably because I've been watching a lot of manifestation videos, but I'll talk about that in another video. And then I want you guys to try this. I want you guys to try this. Hear me out. So try 24 hours with no social media. I promise it's like a game changer. I was off social media for about a week because I needed to focus on my schoolwork, and I tried it. It was very cool. And I was like amazed by, like, I'm not on social media anymore. Like, I was such an addict of social media when I was in middle school because everybody was like trying to look like everybody else, things like that. And I was just like, I don't care about Snapchat, I don't care about Instagram, I'm rarely on it. I'm more so on TikTok now. But anyways. But yeah, that is it for today's video. That was a lot of talking for me. But yeah, what did you guys think about that? I want to know. Make sure you write your comments down below. And I'll see you guys next video. Don't forget to subscribe, like, comment, do all that fun stuff. And make sure you guys follow my social medias, which will be on the screen. And oh yeah, if you guys see my Twitter on the screen, I'm rarely on that. Like, I'm never on Twitter because I get so many notifications about Twitter. And I don't really care about Twitter that much. So anyways, thank you guys so much for watching this video on how to build confidence. And yeah, this is video mostly me talking, but I hope you guys like this video and give me some suggestions and things like that. And I'll see you guys next Friday for our next video. I'm not really sure what I'm doing yet. I'll think about it. But yeah. I'll see you guys in the next video, and enjoy the bloopers after this video, because I thought of the same thing now where I put like all my bloopers of this video into this video, if that makes sense. Like the bloopers of this video at the end of the video, you'll get it. Anyways, I'll see you guys next Friday.